I have solved 200 LeetCode problems, still I'm not confident. How many problems do I need to solve to gain that confidence in clear interviews? Where do I need to start? If these kind of questions comes to your mind when you hear LeetCode or data success and algorithms, then this particular video will definitely going to help you. I have covered the 5 steps formula or the strategies that will help you master LeetCode or improve your approach. I have discussed each step in detail, so make sure you watch the video till the end. The third step is the most crucial one, so make sure you watch that at least. In the past, I have solved more than 1,000 problems for DSA and cleared DSA interviews of Microsoft, Meta, Amazon, and many other startups. I have given a detailed roadmap how you can do it too. Without any further ado, let's get started and do join our Telegram group for more job-related updates. I have shared the link in the description below. So the first category of people are the ones who are able to solve a problem, but they take a lot of time. Now imagine you are in an interview and the interview is scheduled for 45 minutes. The interviewer had taken out 3 problems for the interview, but if you take 30 minutes or 35 minutes for just one problem, then there is no point of having good knowledge of DSA or having to solve that problem at all. So how you can improve this particular problem is pretty easy and have been told across the board. I have also mentioned this a lot of time in the past, just time bomb approach. Every question that you solve on LeetCode, what you have to do, now LeetCode has themselves have provided a stopwatch, like you can count the time in which you were able to solve this particular problem. When it comes to medium questions, you are expected in an interview, like in companies like Meta, Google, Amazon, you are expected to complete the medium level question in 10 to 15 minutes. At least you should start coding the main logic of the question. So keep the stopwatch in a way, okay, if you're preparing for big tech companies, you should be able to think of the logic, start implementing, validate the test cases in the first 10 to 12 minutes, and then you have that confidence, okay, you are ready. You will have the confidence that you will be able to clear interviews at big tech companies. So in conclusion, these kind of people are the ones who are good at problem solving, who are able to solve problems, but they have a speed issue. They're solving it a bit slow, and that's okay with practice, that can be improved. Before I move forward, I want to call out one thing. Definitely DSA is hard. Definitely DSA is time consuming. It takes a lot of effort, and there could be a possibility that it may get obsolete with time. Apparently what you are learning DSA is for nothing. You will not be solving the tree problem in your job, right? You will be building a recommendation system. So you need to understand what's going behind under the hood and how DSA is being consumed there. But don't you worry, traditional colleges won't help you with this. Mirai School of Technology can help you here, master LeetCode and also learn along the way how these are being consumed in the industry. They aren't just teaching you LeetCode, they are actually preparing you for the AI revolution, making you learn and understand how the things are working today in the AI world. And these are the same people who created coding blogs and taught 50,000 plus students who are doing amazing in their career working at big tech companies like Google, Meta and so on and so forth. They'll be teaching advanced DSA, for instance, dynamic programming for model optimization, graph algorithms for neural networks, and tree data structure for decision making. You're not just learning sorting, you'll be building Netflix-like recommendation engines. And by year 2, you will be applying the DSA in machine learning pipelines, Tesla level project detection, and much more. And the best part, you will work with real industry tools from day 1, MacBook from day 1, ChatGPT, GitHub Copilot, and 15 other AI tools. Not just that, they will not restrict themselves just to teaching. They will help you with 100% placement support. They will help you with resume building, mock interviews. They will also mentor you to get into big tech companies. Plus, a paid third year internship is also there in the program. You need to attend a test, a scholarship, exam plus scholarship test, which is Mirai National Screening Test. 60 online questions on AI concept, aptitude and problem solving. And if you perform well, you could get a 100% scholarship. See, the date is 5th of July and the last day to register is 4th of July. So make sure you register with the link mentioned in the description and don't miss this amazing opportunity if you want to ride this AI race. Now coming to the second strategy, which is solving via pattern, identifying the pattern and then solving any DSA problem. Now you have seen on the internet, there are so many pattern sheets, 16 pattern, 22 pattern, 30 pattern sheet have been circulated all across the internet. And similarly, I have also created a proper roadmap DSA pattern as well as practice question sheet. Now Here, I have identified 16 to 20 patterns and also dedicated problems which are associated with those patterns. Now, how this particular thing helps apparently. If you do some kind of problems with a certain pattern in mind, whenever you will see a similar pattern or paradigm, you will be able to implement similar approach in those questions. Now, for instance, for sliding window questions, from the reading the question itself, you will understand they are talking about some k length windows, or either it could be variable, either it could be fixed. And that's how, after solving a few questions on the same pattern, you, whenever you will come across anything similar, you understand, okay, you will think in that direction, okay, I can apply a sliding window. And you start to experience this very often if you have good understanding of the initial set of problems that you've done. And to solve or practice these set of problems, my good friend Siddharth has created the complete sheet on this 20 essential DSA patterns. And he has linked all the questions from LeetCode or any other platform here itself. So you can go ahead and practice. Coming on to the third point, which is my favorite because it's generic and for everyone who is going to start or who face difficulty in approaching a problem. Now, whenever you go on LeetCode and see a medium or a hard problem, I'm not talking about easy problems because they are very trivial and easy to understand and mostly implementation based. Now, when it comes to easy and hard problems, how you exactly need to approach the problem? First, you need to read the problem 2 times. Then you have to pick a pen and paper and then write the test case which are given in this question and solve it on your own. And see if you're able to match the output, like whatever output based on your understanding of reading the question 2 times, were you able to come up to the same result as per the examples given. Once you're able to do it, or what you need to do is you need to either try, so calculate the time complexity of your approach in your mind or in the paper, and then match it with the constraints given for this question. If you think your approach, which is order, maybe order n square or order n, is matching with the constraint. Now, constraints play a major role even if your approach is order n, but then the constraint says n has a value of less than equal to 10 to the power 9, which means you have to do the problem less than order n. And there comes a thing, you have to think in log n direction. And there comes, when it comes log n, you have to think of a pattern of binary search. This is how you approach a problem. Now, constraint, if you're fitting in the constraint, then you are sorted. All you need to do is you have to test a couple of more test cases to be sure about your approach. Either you think about some edge cases on your own and then test it out here and get the output. For the time being, you can just return 0 from this code window, or you can go to the discuss section and see what people are talking about. And somebody would have definitely mentioned some test cases, as you can see here also. The guy has mentioned a lot of test cases. You can test out a few from them and then start implementing your approach. Now, keeping in mind, all these things has to be done in the first 5 to 7 minutes if you're preparing for interviews and keeping a timestamp of 15 minutes for yourself to solve the problem. If you're just practicing out, you can increase the timestamp for initial practice sessions, 20 to 25 minutes, and subsequently you can decrease. Now, the biggest problem with students is when they submit a solution, they see, okay, let me see my submission. So I was able to achieve a wrong answer here for some of the test cases. I don't know how many. Let me quickly see for how many test cases were passed. Okay, 29 test cases passed out of 43. What mistake every student do is they see a particular test case, then they modify their approach, then they again fail, then they so this time 42 passed, only one failed. What they do is they add that edge case and then update their approach. If you're doing so, you are actually fooling yourself because you're updating your approach based on the test case results. Instead, try to think about some difficult edge cases or use the discuss section and test your approach on that and then only submit. See, if you're passing 42 out of 43, then definitely one edge case is missing. But if you're halfway there, then and updating your approach, then that's a problem. So you need to understand updating your approach based on the test case result is kind of fooling yourself. Even when your approach is time optimized, is it implemented the right way? Or are there any better approaches or easier approaches which fits in the right time complexity? That moment you have to go to solutions and see what other people have posted. Check out the most upvoted solutions, or you know, people who have gotten a good accuracy or beated other submitters like by 100% or 90%, so and so forth. And that's how you learn more approaches, or that's how you open up your brain while solving a problem. And this is the most crucial way to improve your problem solving, or to approach lead code problems. Now, the biggest hurdle for every student is how many questions they should be doing on each and every topic to gain confidence, whether it is greedy, whether it is binary search, whether it is graph. Now, if you there are certain categories to it. If you are a student who is preparing for a specific company, then you need to understand that 80% of the questions comes from 20% of the lead code problems. Preparing for a company, or you're doing preparation specifically for getting a job, and you have done DSA in the past, then all you need to do is you have to go on the problem section or the discuss section if you're preparing for a specific company, and go write the particular name of that company, maybe Google, maybe Meta, and then read through the last 6 months of questions that are being asked in the interview experiences. As you can see, that you will be able to cover a lot of questions through this if you'll cover the last 6 months, and you will have that understanding what kind of interview topics are being covered in the recent interviews being taken by this company for so and so forth through so and so forth role. How many questions you'd be doing as a if you're just starting out? Well, that's a very critical question. When it comes to medium level question, if you are able to, you reach that timestamp of 15 minutes to solve a medium question, or you're able to crack the approach, the right approach, then you are at a stage where you can jump onto hard problems. And here comes my fifth point also, where solve a lot of hard problems once you have that initial confidence in DSA, so that you'll be able to cover a lot of topics in quick duration of time. See, in interviews, there could be a probability that they'll ask you a question which you have seen nowhere, and you'll have to do hit and trial thing, and that's where the hard problem solving, a hard lead code problem solving thing comes into picture. So make sure if you have gained enough confidence on your medium level questions, you start solving hard level questions also. If you have a schedule of 3 questions a day, do 2 medium, but do at least 1 hard question, because whenever you do that, you have, and you may take time, that's completely fair, 30, 45, 45 minutes in doing the hard question, but the knowledge you will be getting out of that one hard question is something you will be able to solve multiple medium questions. Let me show you also. If you submit this problem, the trapping rain water is a hard problem, and once you submit it, you will see there are a lot of related questions also. Let me go to the accepted. Okay. So this is the solution has been accepted, and you also see certain related challenges. And once you have solved a hard problem, you will be able to easily solve all the medium related problems. So you don't have to solve them directly. Just go then, and if you are able to think about the approach very quickly, then you know that you have covered 5 medium problems just by solving 1 hard problem. Right, so this was mostly it for the video. I hope you have enjoyed it. If you have still have comments or questions, please make sure to put them in the comments below. I'll be more than happy to answer those. And make sure to check Mirai School of Technology. There are amazing opportunities there also. You can find all the links in the description below, all the notes and the doc also. I'll meet in the next video. Till then, bye-bye. Take care.